Thank you for joining us for this special production of It's a Wonderful Life by Francis Goodrich, Albert Hackett, Frank Capra, and Jo Swerling. Tonight's production stars Chris Dane as George Bailey, Jillian Laganelli as Mary Hatch, Nick Cancelliere as Mr. Potter, Joseph Sibilia as Clarence. Also starring Greg Nugent, Kyle Boringer, Brian Cadena, Lindsay Crescenti, Dennis Quinn, Eric Adams, Connor Adams, John Potito, Jasmine Gonzalez, Nicole Caico, Zack Grinfeld, Megan McGuire, Zach Alexander, Bradley Clarke, Jessica Ma, Sean Bates, Sean Morgan, Sam Friedland, Carissa Hensel, Bianca Kroening, Logan Kelly, Indiana Messier, Sarah Grace Sanders, Heidi Gleichhoff, Celia Warner, Lisa Delia, and Chelsea Nelson Fernandez. We hope you enjoy tonight's production. Thank you for listening.
I owe everything to George Bailey. Help him, dear father.
Joseph, Jesus, and Mary, help my friend, Mr. Bailey.
Help my son, George, tonight.
He never thinks about himself, God. That's why he's in trouble.
George is a good guy. Give him a break, God.
I love him, dear Lord. Watch over him tonight.
Please, God, something's the matter with Daddy.
Please bring Daddy back.
Hello, Joseph. Trouble?
Looks like we'll have to send someone down. A lot of people are asking for help for a man named George Bailey.
George Bailey, yes. Tonight's his crucial night. You're right. We'll have to send someone down immediately. Whose turn is it?
That's why I came to see you, sir. It's that clockmaker's turn again.
Oh, Clarence hasn't gotten his wings yet, has he? We've passed him up right along.
Because, you know, sir, he's got the IQ of a rabbit.
Yes, but he's got the faith of a child. Simple. Joseph, send for Clarence.
You sent for me, sir?
Yes, Clarence. A man down on Earth needs your help.
Splendid! Is he sick?
No. Worse. He's discouraged. At exactly 10:45 p.m. tonight, Earth time, that man will be thinking seriously of throwing away God's greatest gift.
Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. His life! Then I've only got an hour to dress. What are they wearing now?
You will spend that hour getting acquainted with George Bailey.
But, sir, if I should accomplish this mission, might I perhaps win my wings? I've been waiting for over 200 years now, sir, and people are beginning to talk.
What's that book you've got there?
The Adventures of Tom Sawyer.
Clarence, you do a good job with George Bailey, and you'll get your wings.
Oh, thank you, sir, thank you.
Poor George. Sit down.
Sit down? What are...
If you're going to help a man, you want to know something about him, don't you?
Well, naturally, of course.
Well, keep your eyes open. See the town?
Where? I don't see a thing.
Oh, I forgot. You haven't got your wings yet. Now look, I'll help you out. Concentrate. Begin to see something?
Why, yes, this is amazing.
If you ever get your wings, you'll see all by yourself.
Oh, wonderful!
Yippee!
Hey, who's that?
That's your problem. George Bailey.
A boy?
That's him, when he was 12, back in 1919. Something happens here you'll have to remember later on.
And here comes the scared baby, my kid brother, Harry Bailey.
I'm not scared.
Come on, Harry.
Come on, boy, Harry.
Come on, cat.
Make a chain, gang. A chain.
George saved his brother's life that day, but he caught a bad cold which infected his left ear. Cost him his hearing in that ear. It was weeks before he could return to his after-school job at Old Man Gower's drugstore.
Who's that? A king?
That's Henry F. Potter, the richest and meanest man in the county.
So long.
Gotta work.
Go to work, slave.
Go to work, slave.
Hee-haw, hee-haw.
See you later.
I wish I had $1 million.
hot dog. It's me, Mr. Gower. George Bailey.
You're late.
Yes, sir.
Hello, George.
Hello, Mary.
Hello, Violet.
2 cents worth of shoelaces?
She was here first.
I'm still thinking.
Shoelaces?
Please, Georgie. I like him.
You like every boy.
What's wrong with that?
Here you are.
Help me down?
Help you down? Made up your mind yet?
I'll take chocolate.
With coconuts?
I don't like coconuts.
You don't like coconuts? Say, brainless, don't you know where coconuts come from? Look at here, from Tahiti, Fiji Islands, the Coral Sea.
A new magazine? I've never saw it before.
Of course you never. Only us explorers can get it. I've been nominated for membership in the National Geographic Society.
Is this the ear you can't hear on? George Bailey, I'll love you till the day I die.
You know, I'm going out exploring someday. You watch. And I'm going to have a couple of harems and maybe 3 or 4 wives. You wait and see.
George! George!
Yes, sir?
You're not paid to be a canary.
No, sir. What's this? We regret to inform you that your son, Robert, died very suddenly this morning of influenza. Everything possible was done for his comfort. We await instructions from you. Oh, no. Mr. Gower? Do you want something? Anything?
No.
Anything I can do back here?
No.
Well, I'll get them, sir.
Take these capsules over to Mrs. Blaine's. She's waiting for them.
Yes, sir. They have the diphtheria there, don't they, sir? Is it a charge, sir?
Yes, yeah, charge.
Mr. Gower, I think...
I'll get going.
Yes, sir. Oh, man. What do I do? Ask Dad. He knows.
Avast there, Captain Cook. Where are you heading?
I gotta see Pop, Uncle Billy.
Some other time, George.
It's important.
There's a squall in there that's shaping up into a storm.
Hello? Uncle Billy, telephone.
Who is it?
Bank examiner.
Bank examiner. Should have called him yesterday. Switch it inside.
I'm not crying, Mr. Potter.
Well, you're begging, and that's a whole lot worse.
All I'm asking is 30 days more.
Pop!
Just a minute, son. Just 30 short days. I'll dig up that 5,000 somehow.
Shove me up.
Pop!
Have you put any real pressure on those people of yours to pay those mortgages?
Times are bad, Mr. Potter. A lot of these people are out of work.
Then foreclose.
I can't do that. These families have children.
Pop!
They're not my children.
But they're somebody's children.
Are you running a business or a charity ward?
Well, all right.
Not with my money.
Mr. Potter, what makes you such a hard-skulled character? You have no family, no children. You can't begin to spend all the money you've got.
So I suppose I should just give it to miserable failures like you and that idiot brother of yours to spend for me.
Hey, he's not a failure. You can't say that about my father.
George.
You're not. You're the biggest man in town.
Run
along.
Bigger
than him. Bigger than everybody.
Gives you an idea of the Baileys.
I don't let him say that about you, Pop.
All right, son, thanks. I'll talk to you tonight.
Why, that medicine should have been there an hour ago. It'll be over in 5 minutes, Mrs. Blaine. Where's Mrs. Blaine's box of capsules?
Capsules?
Did you hear what I said?
Yes, sir, I...
What kind of tricks are you playing?
You're hurting my sore ear.
You lazy loafer.
Mr. Gower, you don't know what you're doing. You put something wrong in those capsules. I know you're unhappy. You got that telegram, and you're upset, and you put something bad in those capsules. It wasn't your fault, Mr. Gower. Just look and see what you did. Look at the bottle you took the powder from. It's poison, I tell you, poison. I know you feel bad, Aunt. Don't hurt my sore ear again.
No, no, no.
Oh, don't hurt my ear.
Oh, George, George.
Oh, Mr. Gower, I won't ever tell anyone. I know what you're feeling. I won't ever tell a soul. Hope to die, I won't.
Oh, George.
An overnight bag, genuine English cowhide, combination lock, fitted up with brushes, combs.
Nope. Nope, nope, nope. Now look, Joe, now look, I want a big one.
What did you stop it for?
I want you to take a good look at that face.
Who is it?
George Bailey.
Oh, you mean the kid that had his ears slapped back by the druggist?
That's the kid.
It's a good face. I like it. I like George Bailey. Tell me. Did he ever tell anyone about the pills?
Not a soul.
Did he ever marry the girl? Did he ever go exploring?
Well, wait and see.
Big C, I don't want one for one night. I want something for 1,001 nights, with plenty of room for labels from Italy and Baghdad, Samarkand, a great big one.
I see, a flying carpet, huh? I don't suppose you'd like this old secondhand job, would you?
Aw, now you're talking. Gee whiz, I could use this as a raft in case the boat sunk. How much does this cost?
No charge.
That's my trick here, Joe. It sounded as if you said no charge.
That's right.
Well, hey, what's my name doing on it?
A little present from old man Gower. Came down and picked it out himself.
He did? What do you know about that? My old boss.
What boat you sailing on?
Well, I'm working across on a cattle boat.
A cattle boat?
Okay. I like cows. Mr. Gower! Mr. Gower! Thanks ever so much for the bag. It's just exactly what I wanted.
Ah, forget it.
Oh, it's wonderful.
Hope you enjoy it.
Oh. Wish I had $1,000,000. Hot dog!
Thus there, Captain Cook. You got your sea legs yet?
Parlez-vous français? Hey, send us some of them picture postcards, will you, George?
Hey, George, don't take any plugged nickels.
Hey, George, your suitcase is leaking.
Hey, Ernie.
Hey, George.
Hi, Bert.
George.
Now, Ernie, I'm a rich tourist today. How about driving me home in style?
Sure, Your Highness. Hop in. And for the carriage trade, I puts on my hat.
Good afternoon, Mr. Bailey.
Well, hello, Violet. Hey, you look good. That's some dress you got on there.
Oh, this old thing. Why, I only wear it when I don't care how I look.
How would you like?
Yes.
Want to come along, Bert? We'll show you the town.
No, thanks. I'll go see what the wife's doing.
Ah, family man.
Thank you.
George, Harry, you're shaking the house down. Stop it.
Ah, let him alone. I wish I was up there with them.
Harry will tear his dinner suit. George!
All children should be girls.
But if they were all girls, there wouldn't be any... Oh, never mind. Okay. George, Harry, come down to dinner this minute. Everything's getting cold, and you know we've been waiting for you.
Okay, Mom.
Here's a present, for you, Pop.
Oh, you two idiots. George, sit down and have dinner.
I've eaten.
Well, aren't you going to finish dressing for your graduation party? Look at you.
I don't care. It's George's tux.
If you lay a hand on me, I'll hit you with this broom.
Annie, I'm in love with you. There's a moon out tonight.
Boy, oh boy, oh boy. My last meal at the old Bailey boarding house.
Oh, my lands. My blood pressure.
Pop, can I have the car? I'm going to take over a lot of plates and things.
What plates?
Oh, Mom, I'm a chairman of the Eats Committee, and we only need a couple of dozen.
Oh, no, you don't. Harry, now, not my best Haviland.
Aw, let him have the plates, Mother.
Hope you have a good trip, George. Uncle Billy and I are going to miss you.
I'm going to miss you too, Pop. What's the matter? You look tired.
Oh, I had another tussle with Potter today.
Oh.
I thought when we put him on the board of directors, he'd ease up on us a little bit.
I wonder what's eating that old money-grubbing buzzard anyway.
Oh, he's a sick man. Frustrated and sick. Sick in his mind, sick in his soul, if he has one. Hates everybody that has anything that he can't have. Hates us mostly, I guess.
Gangway, gangway! So long, Pop!
So long, son.
Got a match?
Very funny, very funny.
Put those things in the car, and I'll get your tie and studs together.
Okay, Mom. You coming later? You coming later, George.
What do you mean? Be bored to death?
Couldn't want a better death. Lots of pretty girls. And we're going to use that new floor of yours tonight, too.
I hope it works.
No gin tonight, son.
Aw, Pop. Just a little.
No, son. Not one drop.
Boys and girls and music, why in the hell do they need gin?
Now, Father, did I act like that when I graduated from high school?
Pretty much. You know, George, wish we could send Harry to college with you. Your mother and I talked it over half the night.
Well, we have that all figured out. You see, Harry will take my job at the building and loan, work there for 4 years, then he'll go.
He's pretty young for that job.
Well, no younger than I was.
Maybe you were born older, George.
How's that?
I say, maybe you were born older. I suppose you've decided what you're going to do when you get out of college.
Well, you know what I've always talked about. Build things, design new buildings. Plan modern cities, all that stuff I was talking about.
Still after that first million before you're 30.
No, I'll settle for half that in cash.
Of course, it's just a hope, but you wouldn't consider coming back to the building and loan, would you?
Well, I... Annie, why don't you draw up a chair? You'd be more comfortable and you could hear everything that's going on.
I would if I thought I'd hear anything worth listening to.
You would, huh?
I know it's soon to talk about it.
Now, Pop, I couldn't. I couldn't face being cooped up for the rest of my life in a shabby little office. I'm sorry, Pop. I didn't mean that remark. But this business of nickel and dimes and spending all your life trying to figure out how to save 3 cents on a length of pipe, I'd go crazy. I want to do something big and something important.
You know, George, I feel that in a small way we're doing something important, satisfying a fundamental urge. It's deep in the race for a man to want his own roof and walls and fireplace, and we're helping him to get those things in our shabby little office.
I know, Dad. I wish I felt, but I've been hoarding pennies like a miser in order to... Well, most of my friends have already finished college. I feel like if I don't get away, I'd bust!
Yes. You're right, son.
You see what I mean, don't you, Pop?
This town is no place for any man unless he's willing to crawl to Potter. You've got talent, son. You get yourself an education and get out of here.
Pop, do you want a shock? I think you're a great guy. Oh, did you hear that, Annie?
I heard it. About time one of you lunkheads said it.
I'm gonna miss old Annie. Pop, I think I'll get dressed and go over to Harry's party.
Have a good time, son.
Thank you.
Here you are.
You know my kid brother, George. I'm going to put him through college.
Here comes George. Hello, hee-haw.
Oh, Sam Wainwright, how are you? When did you get here?
Oh, this afternoon. I thought I'd give the kids a treat.
Old college graduate now, huh?
Yeah, old Joe College Wainwright, they call me. Well, freshman, looks like you're going to make it after all.
Yep.
Harry, you're the guy I want to see. Coach has heard all about you.
He has?
Yeah, he's followed every game and his mouth's watering. He wants me to find out if you're going to come along with us.
Well, I gotta make some dough first.
Well, you better make it fast. We need great ends like you, not broken down old guys like this one.
Hee-haw, hee-haw.
Hee-haw!
George, welcome back.
Hello, Mr. Partridge. How are you?
Putting a pool under this floor was a great idea. Saved us another building. Now, Harry, Sam, have a lot of fun. There's lots of stuff to eat and drink. Lots of pretty girls around.
Hey, George.
Hello, Violet.
Hello. What am I, a bid?
George.
Hiya, Jackie. Well, it's old home week.
Do me a favor, will you, George?
What's that?
Well, you remember my kid's sister, Mary?
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Mama wants you, Jackie. Mama wants you, Jackie. Remember?
Dance with her, will you?
Aw, me? I feel funny enough already with all these kids.
Aw, come on, be a sport. Just dance with her one time and you'll give her the thrill of her life.
Aw, go on.
Hey, sis!
Well, excuse me, Violet. Don't be long, Jackie. I don't want to be a wet nurse for...
And the next thing I know, some guy came up and tripped me. That's the reason why I came in fourth. If it hadn't been for that, that race would have been a cinch. I tried to find out who it was later, but I couldn't find out. Nobody ever tell you whoever it was because they'd be scared. They know. What kind of...
You remember, George. This is Mary. Well, I'll be seeing you.
Well, well, well.
Now, to get back to my story, see... Hey, this is my dance.
Oh, why don't you stop annoying
me? Well,
people?
I'm sorry. Hey.
Well, hello.
Hello. You look at me as if you didn't know me.
Well, I don't.
You've passed me on the street almost every day.
Me?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-uh. That was a little girl named Mary Hatch. That wasn't you.
Oi, oi, oi. The big Charlton contest. The prize? A genuine loving cup. Those not tapped by the judges will remain on the floor. Let's go!
I'm not very good at this.
Neither am I.
Okay, what can we lose?
What's the matter, Othello? Jealous? Did you know there's a swimming pool under this floor? And did you know that button behind you causes this floor to open up? And did you further know that George Bailey is dancing right over that crack? And I've got the key.
Buffalo gals, can't you come out tonight?
Can't you come out tonight?
Can't you come out tonight? Buffalo gals, can't you come out tonight and dance by the light of the moon?
Hot dog, just like an organ.
Beautiful.
and I told Harry I thought he'd be bored to death. Oh, you should have seen the commotion in that locker room. I had to knock down 3 people to get this stuff we're wearing here. Here, let me hold that old wet dress of yours.
Do I look as funny as you do?
I guess I'm not quite the football type. You look wonderful. You know, if it wasn't me talking, I'd say you were the prettiest girl in town.
Well, why don't you say it?
Well, I don't know. Maybe I will say it. How old are you anyway?
18.
18? Why, it was only last year you were 17.
Too young or too old?
Oh, no, just right. Your age fits you. Yes, sir, you look a little older without your clothes on. I mean, without a dress. You look older, I mean younger. You look just,
Uh-huh.
Oh.
Sir, my train, please?
A pox upon me for a clumsy lout. Your caboose, m'lady.
You may kiss my hand.
Hey, Mary.
As was lumbering down the street, down the street, down the street.
Okay, then I'll throw a rock at the old Granville house.
Oh no, don't. I love that old house.
No, you see, you make a wish and then you try and break some glass. You gotta be a pretty good shot nowadays, too.
Oh no, George, don't. It's full of romance, that old place. I'd like to live in it.
In that place?
Uh-huh.
I wouldn't live in it as a ghost. Now watch, right on the second floor there.
What'd you wish, George?
Well, not just one wish. A whole hatful, Mary. I know what I'm going to do tomorrow, and the next day, and the next year, and the year after that. I'm shaking the dust of this crummy little town off my feet, and I'm going to see the world. Italy, Greece, the Parthenon, the Colosseum. Oh, and then I'm coming back here, and I'll go to college, and I'll see what they know. And then I'm going to build things. I'm going to build airfields. I'm going to build skyscrapers 100 stories high. I'm going to build bridges a mile long. You gonna throw a rock? Well, hey, that's a pretty good shot. What'd you wish, Mary?
Buffalo gals, can't you come out tonight?
Can't you come out tonight? Can't you come out tonight?
Buffalo gals, can't you come out tonight?
And dance by the light of the moon. What'd you wish for when you threw that rock?
Oh, no.
Come on, tell me.
If I told you, it might not come true.
What does he want, Mary? What do you want? You want the moon? Just say the word, and I'll throw a lasso around and I'll pull it down. Hey, that's a pretty good idea. I'll give you the moon, Mary.
I'll take it. And then what?
Well, then you could swallow it, and it all dissolves, see? And the moonbeams would shoot out of your fingers and your toes and the ends of your hair. Am I talking too much?
Yes, why don't you just kiss her instead of talking her to death?
How's that?
Why don't you kiss her instead of talking her to death?
Oh, I want me to kiss her, huh?
Youth is wasted on the wrong people.
Hey, hold on. I'll come back out here. I'll show you some kissing. Mary? Okay, I give up. Where are you?
Over here in the hydrangea bushes.
Here you are. Catch. Oh, wait a minute. What am I doing? Well, this is a very interesting situation.
Please give me my robe.
A man doesn't get in a situation like this every day.
I'd like to have my robe.
Well, not in Bedford Falls, anyway.
Ouch!
A gesundheit. This requires a little thought here.
George Bailey, give me my robe.
I've heard about things like this, but I've never.
Shame on you. I'm going to tell your mother on you.
Oh, my mother's way up on the corner there.
I'll call the police!
They're way downtown. They'd be on my side, too.
I'm going to scream!
Maybe I could sell tickets. Let's see. No, the point is, in order to get this robe, I've got it. I'll make a deal with you, Mary.
George! George! Come on home, quick. Your father's had a stroke.
Mary, I'm sorry. I've got to go.
Come on, George. Let's hurry.
Did you get a doctor?
Yes. Campbell's there now.
I think that's all we'll need you for, George. I know you're anxious to make a train.
I have a taxi waiting downstairs. I want the board to know that George gave up his trip to Europe to help straighten things out here these past few months. Good luck to you at school, George.
Thanks.
Now we come to the real purpose of this meeting, to appoint a successor for our dear friend, Peter Bailey.
Mr. Chairman, I'd like to get to my real purpose.
Wait just a minute now.
Wait for what? I claim this institution is not necessary to this town. Therefore, Mr. Chairman, I make a motion to dissolve this institution and turn its assets and liabilities over to the receiver.
George, you hear what that buzzard...
Mr. Chairman, it's too soon after Peter Bailey's death to discuss chloroforming the building and loan.
Peter Bailey died 3 months ago. I second Mr. Potter's motion.
Very well. In that case, I'll ask the two executive officers to withdraw. But before you go, I'm sure the whole board wishes to express its deep sorrow at the passing of Peter Bailey.
Thank you very much.
It was his faith and devotion that are responsible for this organization.
I'll go further than that. I'll say that to the public, Peter Bailey was the building and loan.
Oh, that's fine, Potter, coming from you, considering you probably drove him to his grave.
Peter Bailey was not a businessman. That's what killed him. Oh, I don't mean any disrespect to him, God rest his soul. He was a man of high ideals, so-called. But ideals without common sense can ruin this town. Now, you take this loan here to Ernie Bishop, you know, that fellow that sits around all day on his brains in his taxi, you know. Well, I happen to know the bank turned down this loan, but he comes here and we're building him a house worth $5,000. Why?
Well, I handled that, Mr. Potter. You have all the papers there, his salary, insurance. I can personally vouch for his character.
Oh, a friend of yours.
Yes, sir.
You see, if you shoot pool with some employee here, you can come and borrow money. What does that get us? A discontented, lazy rabble instead of a thrifty working class. And all because a few starry-eyed dreamers like Peter Bailey stir them up and fill their heads with a lot of impossible ideas. Now, I say...
Yeah, just a minute. Now, hold on, Mr. Potter. You're right when you say my father was no businessman. I know that. Why he ever started this cheap penny-ante building and loan, I'll never know. But neither you nor anybody else can say anything against his character, because his whole life was... Why, in the 25 years since he and Uncle Billy started this thing, he never once thought of himself. Isn't that right, Uncle Billy? He didn't save enough money to send Harry to school, let alone me. But he did help a few good people get out of your slums, Mr. Potter, and what's wrong with that? Why, you're all businessmen here. Doesn't it make them better citizens? Doesn't it make them better customers? You said... What'd you say just a minute ago? They had to wait and save their money before they even ought to think of a decent home? Wait! Wait for what? Until their children grow up and leave them? Until they're so old and broken down that they... Do you know how long it takes a working man to save $5,000? I'll just remember this, Mr. Potter. This rabble you're talking about, they do most of the working and paying and living and dying in this community. Well, is it too much to have them work and pay and live and die in a couple of decent rooms and a bath? Well, anyway, my father didn't think so. People were human beings to him, but to you, a warped, frustrated old man, they're cattle. Well, in my book, he died a much richer man than you'll ever be.
I'm not interested in your book. I'm talking about the building and loan.
Oh, I know very well what you're talking about. You're talking about something you can't get your fingers on and it's galling you. That's what you're talking about, I know. Well, I've said too much. You're the board here. You do what you want with this thing. Just one thing more, though. This town needs this measly one-horse institution, if only to have some place where people can come without crawling to Potter. Come on, Uncle Billy.
Sentimental hogwash. I want my motion.
Boy, oh boy. That was telling him, George, old boy. You shut his big mouth. You should have heard him.
What happened? We heard a lot of yelling.
Well, we're being voted out of business after 25 years. Easy come, easy go.
Here it is. Help wanted. Female.
You still want me to hang around, George? Or...
Yeah, I'll be right down.
Hey, you'll miss your train. You're a week late for school already. Go on.
Wonder what's going on in there.
Oh, never mind. Don't worry about that. They're putting us out of business. So what? I can get another job. I'm only 55.
56.
Go on. Go on. Hey, look. You gave up your boat trip. Now you don't want to miss college too, do you?
George, George, they voted Potter down. They want to keep it going.
Whoopee! Yay!
But they've got one condition, only one condition.
What's that?
That's the best part of it. They've appointed George here as executive secretary to take his father's place.
Oh no, but Uncle Billy.
You can keep him on. That's all right. As secretary, you can hire anyone you like.
Dr. Campbell, now let's get this thing straight. I'm leaving right now. I'm going to school. This is my last chance. Uncle Billy here, he's your man.
But George, they'll vote with Potter otherwise.
No.
That's right. Not only that, but he gave his school money to his brother Harry and sent him to college. Harry became a football star, made second team All-American.
Yes, but George.
George got 4 years older, waiting for Harry to come back and take over the building and loan.
Oh, there are plenty of jobs around for somebody that likes to travel. Look at this. There. A Venezuela oil field. Wanted. Man with construction experience. And here's the Yukon. Right here. Wanted. Man with engineering experience. Huh. There she blows! Okay, you know what the three most exciting sounds in the world are?
Uh-huh. Breakfast is served. Lunch is served.
No. Anchor chains, plane motors, and train whistles.
Peanut?
Oh, there's the professor now. Old Professor Phi Beta Kappa Bailey, All-American.
Well, if it isn't George Geographic Explorer Bailey. What, no husky dogs? No sled? Uncle Billy, you haven't changed a bit.
Nobody ever changes around here. You know that.
Oh, am I glad to see you.
Say, where's Mother?
Oh, she's home cooking the fatted calf. Come on, let's go.
Oh, wait. Wait a minute.
Hello?
How do you do?
Ruth Dakin?
Ruth Dakin Bailey, if you don't mind.
Huh?
Well, I wired you. I had a surprise. Here she is. Meet the wife.
Well, what do you know? Wife.
Well, how do you do? Congratulations. Congratulations? What am I doing? Oh, this is great. Harry, why didn't you tell somebody? And what's a pretty girl like you doing with this two-headed brother of mine?
Well, I'll tell you. It's purely mercenary. My father offered him a job.
Oh, he gets you and a job? Well... Harry's cup runneth over.
George, about the job. Ruth spoke out of turn. I never said I'd take it. You've been holding the bag here for 4 years and... Well, I won't let you down, George. I would like to... Oh, wait a minute. I forgot the bags. I'll be right back.
It was a surprise to me. This is the new Mrs. Bailey. My nephew's wife. Old friend of the family.
Oh, of course. I've heard him speak of you.
And I want to tell you, we're going to give the biggest party this town ever saw.
Here, have some popcorn. George, that's all Harry talks about.
Hey, Ruth, what about this job?
Oh, well, my father owns a glass factory in Buffalo. He wants to get Harry started in the research business.
Is it a good job?
Oh, yes, very. Not much money, but a good future, you know? Harry's a genius at research. My father fell in love with him.
And you did, too.
Oh boy, oh boy, oh boy. I feel so good I could spit in Potter's eye. I think I will. What did you say, huh? Oh, maybe I better go home. Where's my hat? Oh, thank you, George. Which one is mine?
It's the middle one, Uncle Billy.
Oh, thank you, George. Old boy, old boy. Now look, if you'll point me in the right direction, would you do that, George?
Right down here.
Old building and loan, pal, huh?
Oh, now you just turn this way and you go right straight down, okay?
That way, huh? I'm all right. I'm all right. The sweetest flower that grows.
Hello, Mom.
That's for nothing. How do you like her?
Oh, she's swell.
Looks like she can keep Harry on his toes.
Well, keep him out of Bedford Falls, anyway.
Did you know that Mary Hatch is back from school?
Mm-hmm.
Came back 3 days ago.
Hmm.
Nice girl, Mary.
Hmm.
Kind that will help you find the answers, George.
Hmm.
Oh, stop that grunting.
Hmm.
Can you give me one good reason why you shouldn't call Mary?
Yeah, sure. Sam Wainwright.
Hmm?
Yeah, Sam's crazy about Mary.
Well, she's not crazy about him.
Well, how do you know? Did she discuss it with you?
No.
Well, then how do you know?
Well, I've got eyes, haven't I? Why, she lights up like a firefly whenever you're around.
Oh.
And besides, Sam Wainwright's away in New York, and you're here in Bedford Falls.
And all's fair in love and war?
I don't know about war.
Mother, you know I can see right through you, right back to your back collar button. Trying to get rid of me, huh?
Uh-huh.
Well, here's your hat. What's your hurry? All right, Mother, old building the gnome pal. I think I'll go out and find a girl and do me some passionate necking.
Oh, George.
Now, if you'll just point me in the right direction. Oh, this direction. Good night, Mrs. Bailey.
Excuse me.
Now, wait a minute.
I think I got a date. But stick around, fellas, just in case, huh? Hello, Georgie Porgy.
Hello, V.
What gives?
Nothing.
Where are you going?
Oh, I'll probably end up down at the library.
George, don't you ever get tired of just reading about things?
Yeah. Well, what are you doing tonight?
Not a thing.
Are you game, V? Let's make a night of it.
Oh, I'd love it, Georgie. What'll we do?
Let's go out in the field and take our shoes off and walk through the grass.
Huh?
I thought we can go up to the falls. It's beautiful up there in the moonlight. And there's a green pool up there and we can swim in it. Then we can climb Mount Bedford and smell the pines and watch the sunrise against the peak. And we'll stay up there the whole night and everybody will be talking. It'll be a terrific scandal.
George, have you gone crazy? Walk in the grass in my bare feet. Why, it's 10 miles up to Mount Bedford.
Shh.
You think just because
okay, just forget about the whole thing.
What are you doing? Picketing?
Hello, Mary. I just happened to be passing by.
Yeah, so I noticed. Have you made up your mind?
How's that?
Have you made up your mind?
About what?
About coming in. Your mother just phoned and said you were on your way over to pay me a visit.
Oh, my mother just called you. Well, how did she know?
Didn't you tell her?
I didn't tell anybody. Well, I just went for a walk and happened to be passing by and... Oh, what are you... I went for a walk, that's all.
I'll be downstairs, Mother. All right, dear. Well, are you coming in or aren't you?
Well, I'll come in for a minute, but I didn't tell anybody I was coming over here. When did you get back?
Tuesday.
And where'd you get that dress?
Do you like it?
It's all right. I just thought you'd go back to New York, like Sam and Ingi and the rest of them.
Oh, I worked there for a couple of vacations, but I don't know. I guess I was homesick.
Homesick? For Bedford Falls?
Yes, and my family and... Oh, everything. Wouldn't you like to sit down?
All right, for a minute. I still can't understand it, though. You know, I didn't tell anybody I was coming here.
Would you rather leave?
No, I don't want to be rude.
Well, then sit down.
George laughs as the moon. Some joke, huh? Well, I see it still smells like pine needles in here.
Thank you. And dance by the light.
What's the matter? Oh, yeah. Well,
It was nice about your brother Harry and Ruth, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah. Yeah, you know, that's all right.
Well, don't you like her?
Well, of course I like her. She's a peach.
Oh, it's just marriage in general you're not enthusiastic about, huh?
No, marriage is all right for Harry and Jackie and Sam and you.
Mary! Who's down there with you?
It's George Bailey, Mother.
George Bailey? What's he want?
I don't know. What do you want?
Me? Not a thing. I just came in to get warm.
He's making violent love to me, Mother.
You tell him to go right back home. And don't you leave the house either. Sam Wainwright promised to call you from New York tonight.
But your mother needed, you know, I didn't come here to...
What did you come here for?
I don't know. You tell me. You're supposed to be the one that has all the answers. You tell me.
Why don't you go home?
Well, that's where I'm going. I don't know why I came here in the first place. Good night.
Good night.
Mary, the telephone. It's Sam.
I'll get it.
Mary, he's waiting.
Hello?
Forgot my hat.
Hee-haw, hello. Sam, how are you?
Aw, great. Gee, it's good to hear your voice again.
Oh, well, that's awfully sweet of you, Sam. There's an old friend of yours here, George Bailey.
You mean old Mossback George?
Yes, old Mossback George.
Hee-haw, put him on.
Wait a minute, I'll call him. George!
He doesn't want to speak to George, you idiot.
He does so. He asked for him.
Hello, Sam.
Well, George Bailey Afaki. Hey, a fine pal you are. What are you trying to do, steal my girl?
What do you mean? No, nobody's trying to steal your girl. Here's Mary.
No, wait a minute. I want to talk to both of you. Tell Mary to get on the extension.
Here, you take it. You tell him.
Mother's on the extension. We can both hear. Come here. We're listening, Sam.
I have a big deal coming up that's going to make us all rich. George, you remember that night in Martini's bar where you told me you read someplace about making plastics out of soybeans?
Huh? Yeah. Soybeans, yeah.
Well, Dad snapped up the idea. He's going to build a factory outside of Rochester. How do you like that?
Rochester? Well... Why Rochester?
Well, why not? Can you think of anything better?
I don't know. Well, why not right here? You remember that old Tool Machinery Works? You tell your father he can get that for a song and all the labor he wants, too. Half the town was thrown out of work when they closed down.
That's so? Well, I'll tell him. Hey, that sounds great! Oh, baby, I knew you'd come through. Now, here's the point. Mary, you're in on this, too. Now, listen. Have you got any money?
Money? Yeah, little.
Well, now listen. I want you to put every cent you've got in our stock, you hear? And George, I may have a job for you. That is, unless you're still married to that broken-down building and loan. This is the biggest thing since radio, and I'm letting you in on the ground floor. Oh, Mary. Mary.
I'm here.
Would you tell that guy I'm giving him the chance of a lifetime, you hear? The chance of a lifetime.
He says it's a chance of a lifetime.
Now you listen to me. Oh, I don't want any plastics. I don't want any ground floors. I don't want to get married ever to anyone. You understand that? I want to do what I want to do, and you're... Oh, Mary.
George!
Mary.
First Harry, now George. Annie, we're just two old maids now.
You speak for yourself, Miss B.
If either of you two see a stranger around here, it's me.
Hey, look, somebody's driving this cab.
Bert the cop said this over. He said to float away to Happy Land on the bubbles.
Oh, look at this. Champagne.
Good old Bert.
By the way, where are you two going on this here now, honeymoon?
Where are we going? Huh. Look at this. There's the kitty, Ernie. Here, come on, count it, Mary.
I feel like a bootlegger's wife. Look!
You know what we're going to do? We're going to shoot the works a whole week in New York, a whole week in Bermuda, the highest hotels, the oldest champagne, the richest caviar, the hottest music, and the prettiest wife.
Oh, that does it. And what?
Oh, then one, honey.
After that, who cares?
Well, that does it. Oh, come here.
Don't look now, but there's something funny going on over there at the bank. George, I've never really seen one, but that's got all the earmarks of a run.
Hey, Ernie, if you got any money in the bank, you better hurry.
George, let's not stop. Let's go.
Just a minute, dear. Oh.
Please, let's not stop, George.
I'll be back in a minute, Mary. Hello, everybody. Mrs. Thompson, how are you? Charlie, what's the matter here? Can't you get in? What is this, Uncle Billy? A holiday?
George.
Come on in, everybody. That's right. Just come in.
George, can I see you a minute?
Now, look, why don't you all sit down? There are a lot of seats over there. Just make yourselves at home. Why didn't you call me?
I just did, but they said you left. This is a pickle, George. This is a pickle.
All right, now, what happened? How did it start?
How does anything like this ever start? All I know is the bank called our loan.
When?
About an hour ago. I had to hand over all of our cash.
All of it?
Every cent of it. And it was still less than we owe.
Holy mackerel.
And then I got scared, George. And then I closed and closed the doors, and I...
The whole town's gone crazy.
Yes? Hello? George? It's Potter.
Hello?
George, there's a rumor around town that you've closed your doors. Is that true?
No, it's not.
Oh, well, I'm glad to hear that. George, are you all right? Do you need any police?
Police? What for?
Well, mobs get pretty ugly sometimes, you know. George, I'm going all out to help in this crisis. I've just guaranteed the bank sufficient funds to meet their needs. They'll close up for a week and then reopen.
He just took over the bank.
I may lose a fortune, but I'm willing to guarantee your people too. Just tell them to bring their shares over here, and I will pay them 50 cents on the dollar.
Oh, you never miss a trick, do you, Potter? Well, you're gonna miss this one.
If you close your doors before 6 p.m., you'll never reopen.
Now just remember that this thing isn't as black as it appears. Okay, I have some news for you folks. I've just talked to Old Man Potter, and he's guaranteed cash payments at the bank. The bank's going to reopen next week.
Did he guarantee this place?
Well, no, Charlie. I didn't even ask him. We don't need Potter over here.
I'll take mine now.
No, but you're thinking of this all wrong. As if I had the money back in a safe. The money's not here. Your money's in Joe's house, right next to yours, and in the Kennedy house, and Miss Macklin's house, and 100 others. Why you're lending them money to build, and then they're going to pay it back to you as best they can. And now what are you going to do? Foreclose on them?
I got $242 in here, and $242 isn't going to break anybody.
Okay, Tom. All right, here you are. You signed this to get your money in 60 days.
60 days?
Well, now that's what you agreed to when you brought shares.
Tom, did you get your money?
No.
Well, I did. Old Man Potter will pay 50 cents on the dollar for every share you
only
got.
50 cents on the dollar?
What is I'll he thinking? It.
Yes, cash.
Well, what do you say?
No, Tom, you have to stick to your original agreement. Now give us 60 days on this.
Okay, let's go.
Are you going to go to Potter's?
Better to get half than nothing.
Now listen to me. I beg of you not to do this thing. If Potter gets a hold of this building and loan, there'll never be another decent house built in this town. He's already got charge of the bank. He's got the bus line. He's got the department stores. And now he's after us. Why? Well, it's very simple. Because we're cutting in on his business. That's why. Because he wants to keep you living in his slums and paying the kind of rent he decides. Joe, you lived in one of those houses, didn't you? Well, have you forgotten what he charged for that broken-down shack? And you remember last year when things weren't looking so well and you couldn't make your payments? You didn't lose your house, did you? Do you think Potter would have let you keep it? Oh, can't you understand what's happening here? Don't you see what's happening? Potter isn't selling. Potter's buying. And why? Because we're panicky, and he's not. That's why. He's picking up some bargains. Now, we can get through this thing all right. We've got to stick together, though. We have got to have faith in each other.
But my husband hasn't worked in over a year, and I need money.
How am I going to live until the bank opens? I need cash!
Can't feed my kids on faith?
How much do you need?
Hey, I got $2,000 here. Here's $2,000. This'll tide us over until the bank reopens. All right, how much do you need?
$242.
Tom, just enough to tide you over till the bank reopens.
I'll take $242.
All right, there you are.
That'll close my account.
Your account's still here. That's a loan. Okay, all right, next.
I got $300 here, George.
Now, what'll it take till the bank reopens? What do you need?
Well, I suppose... $20?
$20. Now you're talking. Fine. Thank you. Thank you so much. All right. Now, Mrs. Thompson, how much do you want?
But it's your own money, George.
Oh, never mind about that. How much do you want?
I can get along with 20, all right?
$20. All right, yeah.
And I'll sign a paper.
Oh, you don't have to sign anything. I know you'll pay it back when you can. That's okay. All right, next. Miss Davis.
Could I have $17.50?
$17.50, bless your heart. Of course you can have it. You got 50 cents? Okay, $17.50, there you go.
We're going to make it, George. They'll never close us up today.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Bingo! Oh, we made it! Look! Oh, look! Two! We got $2 left! We're still in business! Well, let's have some of that. Get some glasses, Cousin Tilly. Oh, we're a couple financial wizards.
Those Rockefellers!
Oh, get a tray for these big, great, important simoleons.
We'll save them for seed. A toast!
A toast! A toast to... Papa Dollar and Mama Dollar, and if you want the old building loan to stay in business, you better have a family real quick.
Boy, I wish they were rabbits.
Well, I wish they were too. Okay, let's put them in the safe and see what happens.
Wedding cigars!
Oh. Oh, wedding. Holy mackerel, I'm married. Where's Mary? Mary. Oh, poor Mary. Look, I've got a train to catch. Okay, well, the train's gone. I wonder if Ernie's still here with his taxi cab.
George, there's a call for you.
Look, we get my wife on the phone. She's probably over at her mother's.
Mrs. Bailey's on the phone.
Well, I don't want Mrs. Bailey. I want my wife. Mrs. Bailey. Oh, that is my wife. Okay, here, I'll take it in here. Mary? Hello? Listen, dear, I'm sorry. What? Come home. What home? 320 Sycamore? Well, what? Whose home is that? The Waldorf Hotel?
Hey, this is the company's posters, and the company won't like this.
How would you like to get a ticket next week? Haven't you any romance in you?
Sure I have, but I got rid of it.
What's on this poster? Liver pills? Who wants to see liver pills on their honeymoon? What? They have romantic places, beautiful places, places George wants to go.
Hey, Bert, here he comes.
Come on, we gotta get this up. He's coming.
Who?
The groom, idiot! Come on, get the ladder!
What are they? Ducks?
Get that ladder up there!
Alright, alright.
Hurry up, hurry up, hurry up!
I'm hurrying.
Hiya, good evening, sir. Entree, monsieur. Entree.
Welcome home, Mr. Bailey.
Well, I'll be. Oh, Mary. Mary, where did you... Darling, oh, Mary...
Remember that night we broke the old windows in this old house? This is what I wished for.
Darling, you're wonderful.
Martini, you rented a new house?
Rent? You hear what he say, Mr. Bailey?
What's that?
I owe the house. Me, Giuseppe Martini. I owe my own house. No more we live like pigs in this potter's field. Hurry, Maria.
Yes.
Come on, bring the baby. I'll bring the kids in the car.
Oh, thank you, Mr. Bailey.
All right, kids, here. Get in here, and I'll get right up on the seat there. Yeah, yeah. All right. Get the goat. Get the goat.
Goodbye, everybody.
All in. Mr. and Mrs. Martini, welcome home.
That old George, he's always making a speech. Hee-haw!
Sam Wainwright?
Oh, who cares? Bread, that this house may never know hunger. Salt, that this life may always have flavor.
And wine, that joy and prosperity may reign forever. Enter the Martini Castle!
Look, Mr. Potter, it's no skin off my nose. I'm just your little rent collector, but you can't laugh off this Bailey Park anymore. Look at it.
Congressman Blatz is here to see you.
15 years ago, a half dozen houses stuck here and there. There's the little old cemetery, squirrels, buttercups, daisies. Used to hunt rabbits there myself. Look at it today. Dozens of the prettiest little homes you ever saw. 90% were owned by suckers who used to pay rent to you. Your potter's field, my dear employer, is becoming just that. And all the local yokels make those David and Goliath wisecracks. You know very well why. The Baileys were all chumps. Every one of these homes is worth twice what it cost the building and loan to build. If I were you, Mr. Potter. As I say, it's no skin off my nose. But one of these days, this bright young man is going to be asking George Bailey for a job.
We just stopped in town to take a look at the new factory, and then we're going to drive down to Florida.
Why don't you have your friends join us?
Why, sure. Hey, why don't you kids drive down with us, huh?
Oh, I'm afraid I couldn't get away, Sam.
Still got the nose to the old grindstone, eh? Jane, I offered to let George in on the ground floor in plastics, and he turned me down cold.
Now don't rub it in.
I'm not rubbing it in. Well, I guess we better run along.
Awfully glad to have met you, Mary.
Nice meeting you.
Goodbye.
Goodbye, George.
So long, George. See you in the funny papers.
Goodbye, Sam.
Have fun.
Thanks for dropping around.
To Florida. Hee-haw.
Hee-haw. Thank you, sir. Quite a cigar, Mr. Potter.
You like it? I'll send you a box.
Well, I suppose I'll find out sooner or later, but just what exactly did you want to see me about?
George, now that's just what I like about you so much. George, I'm an old man, and most people hate me. But I don't like them either. So that makes it all even. You know just as well as I do that I run practically everything in this town but the Bailey building and loan. You know also that for a number of years I've been trying to get control of it, or kill it. But I haven't been able to do it. You have been stopping me. In fact, you've beaten me, George. And as anyone in this county can tell you, that takes some doing. Take during the Depression, for instance. You and I were the only ones that kept our heads. You saved the building and loan, and I saved all the rest.
Yeah, well, most people say you stole all the rest.
The envious ones say that, George, the suckers. Now, I have stated my side very frankly. Now, let's look at your side. Young man, 27, 28, married, making, say, 40 a week?
45.
45. Out of which, after supporting your mother and paying your bills, you're able to keep, say, 10, if you skimp. A child or two comes along and you won't even be able to save the 10. Now, if this young man of 28 was a common, ordinary yokel, I'd say he was doing fine, but George Bailey is not a common, ordinary yokel. He's an intelligent, smart, ambitious young man who hates his job, who hates the building and loan almost as much as I do. A young man who's been dying to get out on his own ever since he was born. A young man, the smartest one of the crowd, mind you, a young man who has to sit by and watch his friends go places because he's trapped. Yes, sir, trapped into frittering his life away, playing nursemaid to a lot of garlic eaters. Do I paint a correct picture, or do I exaggerate, George?
Now, what's your point, Mr. Potter?
My point? My point is, I want to hire you.
Hire me?
I want you to manage my affairs, run my properties. George, I'll start you out at $20,000 a year.
$20,000 a year?
You wouldn't mind living in the nicest house in town, buying your wife a lot of fine clothes, a couple of business trips to New York a year, maybe once in a while Europe? You wouldn't mind that, would you, George?
Oh, would I? You're not talking to somebody else around here, are you? You know this is me. You remember me, George Bailey?
Oh, yes, George Bailey, whose ship has just come in. Providing he has brains enough to climb aboard.
Well, what about the building loan?
Oh, confound it, man. Are you afraid of success? I'm offering you a 3-year contract at $20,000 a year starting today. Is it a deal or isn't it?
Well, Mr. Potter, I know I ought to jump at the chance, but I wonder if it'd be possible for you to give me 24 hours to think it over.
Sure. You go on home and talk about it to your wife.
Well, I'd like to do that, yeah.
In the meantime, I'll draw up the papers.
All right, sir.
Okay, George?
Okay, Mr. Potter. No. Now, wait a minute here. I know I don't have to talk to anybody. I know right now, and the answer is no. No, doggone it. You sit around here and you spin your little webs and you think the whole world revolves around you and your money. Well, it doesn't, Mr. Potter. And the whole fast configuration thing, I'd say you were nothing but a scurvy little spider. You... And that goes for you, too. And it goes for you, too!
You wouldn't mind living in the nicest house in town? Buying your wife a lot of fine clothes? Going to New York on a business trip a couple of times a year? Maybe to Europe once in a while?
Well, I know what I'm going to do tomorrow, and the next day, and the next year, and the year after that. While I'm shaking the dust of this crummy little town off my feet, I'm going to see the world, and I'm going to build things. I'm going to build airfields. I'm going to build skyscrapers 100-story high. I'll build bridges a mile long. What does he want, Mary? You want the moon? If you do, just say the word. I'll throw a lasso around it. Pull it down for you.
Buffalo gals, won't you come out tonight? Won't you come out tonight? Won't you come out tonight?
Hi.
Hi.
Mary Hatch, why in the world did you ever marry a guy like me?
To keep from being an old maid.
Oh, you could have married Sam Wainwright or anybody else in town.
I don't want to marry anybody else in town. I want my baby to look like you.
You don't even have a honeymoon. I promised you. You what?
My baby.
You mean... Mary, are you on the nest?
George Bailey lassos stork.
Lassos the stork? You mean you... Oh, what is it? A boy or a girl?
Now, you've probably already guessed that George never leaves Bedford Falls.
No.
Mary had her baby, a boy. Then she had another one, a girl. Day after day, she worked away remaking the old Granville house into a home. Night after night, George came back late from the office. Potter was bearing down hard. Then came a war. Ma Bailey and Mrs. Hatch joined the Red Cross and sewed. Mary had two more babies, but still found time to run the USO. Sam Wainwright made a fortune in plastic hoods for planes. Potter became head of the draft board. Gower and Uncle Billy sold war bonds. Bert the cop was wounded in North Africa, got the Silver Star. Ernie the taxi driver parachuted into France. Harry Bailey topped them all. A Navy flyer, he shot down 15 planes. Two of them as they were about to crash into a transport full of soldiers.
Yes, but George.
George? 4F on account of his ear. George fought the Battle of Bedford Falls.
Hold on. Hold on now, don't you know there's a war on?
Air Raid Warden. Paper drives. Scrap drives. Rubber drives. Like everybody else on VE Day, he wept and prayed. On VJ Day, he wept and prayed again.
Joseph, now show him what happened today.
Yes, sir. This morning, day before Christmas, about 10 a.m., Bedford Falls time.
Hiya, Ernie, look at that.
Oh, it's gonna snow again.
What do you mean it's gonna snow again? Look at the headline!
I know. I think it's marvelous.
Commander Harry Bailey. Hey, Mr. Gower, look at this. The second page. Oh, now look at this. This is for you. This is for you, and this is for you. I'll see you again, everybody. Extra, extra. Read all about it.
George! It's Harry now on long distance from Washington.
Harry? Oh, what do you know about that?
He reversed the charges. It's okay, isn't it?
What do you mean it's okay? It's for a hero. Harry. Oh, you old seven kinds of son of a gun. Congratulations. Oh, how's Mother standing it? She did? Oh, what do you know? Mother had lunch with the president's wife.
Wait till Martha hears about this.
What did they have to eat?
Oh, what do they have to eat? Oh, Harry, you should have seen what they're cooking up in town for you. Oh, are they? Oh, the Navy's going to fly Mother home this afternoon.
In a plane?
What? Uncle Billy? Has Uncle Billy come in yet?
No, he stopped at the bank first.
Oh, he's not here right now, Harry.
George?
But look.
George.
Well, now tell me about it.
That man's here again.
What man?
Bank examiner.
Talk to cousin a minute, will you? I'll be right back. Good morning, sir.
Carter, bank examiner.
Mr. Carter, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Oh, we're all excited around here. My brother just got the Congressional Medal of Honor. The president just decorated him.
Well, I guess they do those things. Well, I trust you had a good year.
Good year? Well, between you and me, Mr. Carter, we're broke.
Yeah, very funny.
Well, now come right in here, Mr. Carter.
Although I shouldn't wonder when you okay reverse charges on personal long-distance calls.
George, shall we hang up?
No. He wants to talk to Uncle Bill. You just hold on.
Now, if you'll cooperate, I'd like to finish with you by tonight. I want to spend my Christmas in Elmira with my family.
Well, I don't blame you at all, Mr. Carter. Just step right up here. We'll fix you up.
December 24th, 8,000. Well, good morning, Mr. Potter. What's the news? Well, Harry
Henry Bailey wins Congressional Medal. That couldn't be one of the Bailey boys. You just can't keep those Baileys down now, can you, Mr. Potter?
How does Slacker George feel about that?
Very jealous. Very jealous. He only lost 3 buttons off his vest. Of course, Slacker George would have gotten 2 of those medals if he had gone.
Bad ear.
Yes. After all, Potter, some people like George had to stay home. Not every heel was in Germany and Japan. Good morning.
I guess you forgot something.
Huh?
You forgot something.
What?
Well, aren't you going to make a deposit?
Sure I am.
Well then, it's usually customary to bring the money with you.
Oh, shucks. I know I had...
How about that one there?
Hmm? Well, I...
Bailey's money envelope. Take me back there. Hurry up. Come on, look sharp.
I know I had... Oh, shucks.
Take me back.
Oh, just make yourself at home, Mr. Carter. I'll get those books for you. Oh, hello, V.
George, can I see you for a second?
Oh, why, of course you can. Come in the office here. Oh, hey, Uncle Billy. Talk to Harry. He's on the telephone.
Hurry, Uncle Billy. Hurry. Long distance. Washington.
Hey, here's Harry on the phone.
Harry, your nephew, remember?
Hello. Yes, Harry. Yes, everything's fine. I should have my head examined. $8,000. It's gotta be somewhere.
Here you are, V.
Character. If I had any character, I'd...
It takes a lot of character to leave your hometown and start all over again.
Oh, George, don't.
Here, now, you're broke, aren't you?
I know, but...
Well, what do you want to do? Hawk your furs in the hat? Want to walk to New York? You know they charge for meals and rent up there just the same as they do in Bedford Falls.
Yeah, sure.
It's a loan. That's my business. Building and loan. Besides, you'll get a job. Good luck to you.
I'm glad I know you, George Bailey.
Say hello to New York for me.
Yeah, I'm sure I will.
Now, let's hear from you. What's the matter? Merry Christmas, V.
Merry Christmas, George.
Mr. Bailey.
Oh, Mr. Carter, I'm sorry. I'll be right with you. Uncle Billion?
Yeah, he's in his office.
What's going on? The bank examiner's here and I...
He's here?
Yeah, he wants the accounts payable. What's the matter with you? Hey, Megan?
Yeah?
Come here a minute. Did you see Uncle Billy with any cash last night?
He had it on his desk, counting it before he closed up.
Now look, did you buy anything?
Nothing. Not even a stick of gum.
All right, now we'll go over every step you took since you left the house.
This way.
All right, and did you put the envelope in your pocket?
Yeah. Maybe.
Maybe, I don't want a maybe, Uncle Billy. We gotta find that money.
I'm no good to you, George.
Listen to me. Do you have any secret hiding place here in the house? Some place you could have put it? Some place to hide the money?
I've been over the whole house. Even in rooms that have been locked since I lost Laura.
Listen to me. Think.
I can't think anymore, George. I can't think anymore. It hurts.
Where's that money, you stupid show-y-old fool? Where's the money? Don't you realize what this means? It means bankruptcy. It's a scandal in prison. That's what it means. One of us is going to jail, and one's not going to be me.
I can't.
Hello, darling.
Hello, Daddy.
Hello, Daddy. Hello, Daddy.
How do you like it?
Bless you.
Did you bring the wreath? The Merry Christmas wreath for the window.
No, I left it at the office.
Is it snowing?
Yeah, it just started.
Where's your coat and hat?
Left them at the office.
What's the matter?
Nothing's the matter. Everything's all right.
Go on, Pete. You're a big boy. You can put the star up. Way up at the top. That's it. Fill in the little bare spot right there. That's it. Isn't it wonderful about Harry? We're famous, George. I'll bet I had 50 calls today about the parade and the banquet. Your mother's so excited and she...
How must she keep playing that?
I have to practice for the party tonight, Daddy.
Mommy says we can stay up till midnight and sing Christmas carols.
Can you sing, Daddy?
Better hurry and shave. The families will be here soon.
Families? I don't want the families over here.
Come on out in the kitchen with me while I finish dinner. Have a hectic day?
Excuse me.
Oh yeah, another big red-letter day for the Baileys.
Excuse me.
Excuse you for what?
I burped.
All right, darling, you're excused. Now go upstairs and see what little Zuzu wants.
Zuzu? What's the matter with Zuzu?
Oh, she's got a cold. She's in bed. Caught it coming home from school. They gave her a flower for a prize and she didn't want to crush it, so she didn't button up her coat.
What is it, a sore throat or what?
Just a cold. The doctor says it's nothing serious.
The doctor? Was the doctor here?
Yes, I called him right away. He says it's nothing to worry about.
Is she running a temperature? What is it?
Just a teensy one. 99.6. She'll be all right.
Gosh, it's this old house. I don't know why we don't have pneumonia. This drafty old barn might as well be living in a refrigerator. Why did we have to live here in the first place and stay around this measly, crummy old town?
George, what's wrong?
Wrong? Everything's wrong. You call this a happy family? Why do we have to have all these kids?
Dad, how do you spell frankincense?
I don't know. Ask your mother.
Where are you going?
Going up to see Zuzu.
He told me to write a play for tonight.
F-R-A-N-K-I...
Hi, Daddy.
What happened to you?
I want a flower.
Wait, now, well, where do you think you're going?
Want to give my flower a drink.
All right. Here, give Daddy the flower. I'll give it a drink.
Look, Daddy. Paste it.
Yeah. All right. I'll paste it this together. There it is. Good as new.
Give the flower a drink.
Now, will you do something for me?
What?
Will you try to get some sleep?
I'm not sleepy. I want to look at my flower.
I know. But you just go to sleep, and then you can dream about it, and it'll be a whole garden.
It will?
Uh-huh.
Telephone!
I'll get it. Hello? Yes, this is Mrs. Bailey. Oh, thank you, Mrs. Welch. I'm sure she'll be all right. The doctor says that she ought to be out of bed in time to have her Christmas dinner.
Is that Zuzu's teacher?
Yes.
Let me speak to her. Hello? Hello? Mrs. Welk. This is George Bray. I'm Zuzu's father. Say, what kind of teacher are you anyway? What do you mean, sending her home like that, half-naked? Do you realize she'll probably end up with pneumonia on account of you?
George!
Is this the sort of thing we pay taxes for, to have teachers like you, as silly, stupid, careless people who send our kids home without any clothes on, you know, maybe my kids aren't the best-dressed kids, maybe they don't have any decent clothes?
Hello, Mrs. Welch. I want to apologize. Hello? Hello?
Oh, that's
stupid.
She's hung
up.
I'll hang her up.
Now, who do you think you are?
Wait a minute. Hello? Who is this? Oh, Mr. Welch. Okay, that's fine. Mr. Welch, give me a chance to tell you what I really think of your wife.
George?
Will you get out? Let me handle this. Hello? Hello? What? Oh, you will, huh? Okay, Mr. Welch, anytime you think you're man enough. Hello? Annie?
Daddy, how do you spell hallelujah?
How should I know? What do you think I am, a dictionary? Tommy, stop that! Stop it! Janie, haven't you learned that silly tune yet? You played it over and over again. Stop it! Stop it! I'm sorry, Mary and Janie. I'm sorry. I didn't mean you. You go on and practice. Pete, I owe you an apology, too. I'm sorry. What do you want to know?
Nothing, Daddy.
What's the matter with everybody? Janie, go on. I told you to practice. Now go on, play.
Oh, Daddy. George, why must you torture the children? Why don't you...
Mary.
Bedford 247, please.
Is Dad in trouble?
Shall I pray for him? Yes, Janie, pray very hard.
Me too?
You too, Tommy. Hello? Uncle Billy?
I'm in trouble, Mr. Potter. I need help. Through some sort of accident, my company shortened their accounts. The bank examiner's up there today, and I've got to raise $8,000 immediately.
Oh, so that's what the reporters wanted to talk to you about.
The reporters?
Yes. They called me up from your building and loan. Oh, there's a man over there from the DA's office, too. He's looking for you.
Please help me, Mr. Potter. Help me, won't you, please? Can't you see what it means to my family? I'll pay you any sort of bonus on the loan, any interest. If you still want the building loan,
George, could it possibly be there's a slight discrepancy in the books?
No, sir. There's nothing wrong with the books. I've just misplaced $8,000. I can't find it anywhere.
You misplaced $8,000?
Yes, sir.
Have you notified the police?
No, sir. I didn't want the publicity. Harry's homecoming tomorrow. And...
They're going to believe that one. What have you been doing, George? Playing the market with the company's money?
No, sir. No, sir, I haven't.
Oh, and what is it? A woman, then? You know, it's all over town that you've been giving money to Violet Bick.
What?
Not that it makes any difference to me, but why did you come to me? Why don't you go to Sam Wainwright and ask him for the money?
I can't get a hold of him. He's in Europe.
Well, what about all your other friends?
They don't have that kind of money, Mr. Potter. You know that. You're the only one in town that can help me.
I see. But I've suddenly become quite important. What kind of security would I have, George? Have you got any stocks?
No, sir.
Bonds? Real estate? Collateral of any kind?
I have some life insurance. A $15,000 policy.
Yes. How much is your equity in it?
$500.
Look at you. You used to be so cocky. You were going to go out and conquer the world. You once called me a warped, frustrated old man. Well, what are you but a warped, frustrated young man? A miserable little clerk crawling in here on your hands and knees and begging for help. No securities, no stocks, no bonds, nothing but a miserable little $500 equity and a life insurance policy. You're worth more dead than alive, George. Why don't you go to the riffraff you love so much and ask them to let you have $8,000? You know why? Because they'd run you out of town on a rail. But I'll tell you what I'm going to do for you, George. Since the state examiner is still here, as a stockholder of the building and loan, I'm going to swear out a warrant for your arrest. Misappropriation of funds, manipulation, malfeasance. Oh, all right, George, go ahead. You can't hide in a little town like this. Bill, this is Potter.
Merry Christmas! Glad you came!
How about some of that good spaghetti?
We got everything!
God. God, dear Father in heaven, I'm not a praying man, but if you're up there and you can hear me, show me the way. I'm at the end of my rope. Show me the way, God.
Are you alright, George? Want someone to take you home?
Why you drink so much, my friend? Please go home, Mr. Bailey. This is Christmas Eve.
Bailey? Which Bailey?
This is Mr. George Bailey.
And the next time you talk to my wife like that, you'll get worse. She cried for an hour. It isn't enough she slaves teaching your stupid kids how to read and write, and you gotta bawl her
you
out?
You get out of here, Mr. Welch.
Now wait. I want to pay for my drink.
Never mind the money. You get out of here, quick!
All right.
You hit my best friend. Get out!
You all right, George?
Who was that?
He's gone. Don't worry. His name is Welch. He don't come into my place no more.
Oh. Welch. That's what I get for praying.
The last time he come in here. You hear that, Nick?
Yes, you bet.
Where's my insurance policy? Oh, here it is.
Oh, no, please, don't go out this way, Mr. Bailey.
I'm all right. I'm all right.
Oh, no, you don't feel so good. Please, don't go away, please.
What do you think you're doing? Now look what you did. My great-grandfather planted this tree. Hey, you! Come back here, you drunken fool! Get this car out of here!
Hey, what's the matter with you? Look where you're going!
I didn't have time to get some stylish underwear. My wife gave me this on my last birthday. I passed away in it. Oh, Tom Sawyer's drying out too. You should read the new book Mark Twain's writing now.
How'd you happen to fall in?
I didn't fall in. I jumped in to save George.
You what? To save me?
Well, I did, didn't I? You didn't go through with it, did you?
Go through with what?
Suicide.
It's against the law to commit suicide around here.
Yeah, it's against the law where I come from, too.
Where did you come from?
Heaven. I had to act quickly. That's why I jumped in. I knew if I were drowning, you'd come to save me. And you see, you did, and that's how I saved you.
Very funny.
Your lip's bleeding, George.
Yeah, I got busted in the jaw and answered a prayer a little while ago.
Oh, no, no, no. I'm the answer to your prayer. That's why I was sent down here.
How do you know my name?
Oh, I know all about you. I've watched you grow up from a little boy.
Oh, what are you, a mind reader or something?
Oh, no.
Well, who are you then?
Clarence Oddbody, AS2.
Oddbody? AS2? What's that AS2?
Angel, second class. Cheerio, my good man.
Oh, brother, I wonder what Martini put in those drinks. Hey, what's with you? What did you say just a minute ago? Why'd you want to save me?
That's what I was sent down for. I'm your guardian angel.
I wouldn't be a bit surprised.
Ridiculous of you to think of killing yourself for money. $8,000.
Yeah. Just things like that. How'd you know that?
I told you. I'm your guardian angel. I know everything about you.
Well, you look about like the kind of an angel I'd get. A sort of fallen angel, aren't you? What happened to your wings?
I haven't won my wings yet. That's why I'm angel second class.
I don't know whether I like it very much, being seen around with an angel without wings.
Oh, I've got to earn them. And you'll help me, won't you?
Sure. Sure. How?
By letting me help you.
Only one way you could help me. You don't happen to have 8,000 bucks on you.
Oh, no, no. We don't use money in heaven.
Oh, that's right. I keep forgetting. Comes in pretty handy down here, bub.
Oh, tut, tut, tut.
Found it out a little late. I'm worth more dead than alive.
Now look, you mustn't talk like that. I won't get my wings with that attitude. You just don't know all that you've done. If it hadn't been for you...
Yeah, if it hadn't been for me, everybody'd be a lot better off. My wife and my kids, my friends... Look, little fella, go off and haunt somebody else, will ya?
No, you don't understand. I've got my job.
Aw, shut up, will you?
This isn't going to be easy. So you think killing yourself would have made everybody happier, eh?
Oh, I don't know. I guess you're right. I suppose it would have been better if I'd never been born at all.
What'd you say?
I said I wish I'd never been born.
Oh, you mustn't say things like that. Wait a minute. That's an idea. What do you think? Yeah, that'll do it. All right. You've got your wish. You've never been born. You don't have to make all that fuss about it.
What did you say?
You've never been born. You don't exist. You haven't a care in the world. No worries, no obligations, no $8,000 to get, no Potter looking for you with the sheriff.
All right, say something else in this ear.
Sure. You can hear out of it.
Well, that's the doggonest thing. I haven't heard anything out of that ear since I was a kid. Must have been that jump in the cold water.
Your lips stopped bleeding too, George.
What do you know about that? What's happened? Hey, it stopped snowing out, hasn't it? What's happened here? All right, come on. As soon as these clothes of ours are dry.
Our clothes are dry.
Huh. What do you know about that? Snow's hotter than I thought. All right, come on. Get on your clothes and we'll stroll up to my car and get a... Oh, I'm sorry. I'll stroll, you fly.
I can't fly. I haven't got any wings.
Right. Yeah, that's right.
What's the matter?
Well, this is where I left my car, and it isn't here.
You have no car.
Well, I had a car, and it was right here. I guess somebody moved it.
Good evening.
Oh, say, hey, where's my car?
I beg your pardon?
My car. I'm the fellow that owns the car that ran into your tree.
What tree?
What do you mean, what tree? This tree here, I ran into it. Cut a big gash in the side of it here.
Oh, you must mean two other trees. You had me worried. One of the oldest trees in Pottersville.
Pottersville? Why, you mean Bedford Falls.
I mean Pottersville. Don't you think I know where I live? What's the matter with you?
Oh, I don't know. Either I'm off my nut or he is. Or you are.
It isn't me.
Oh, maybe I left my car at Martini's. Come on, Gabriel.
Clarence.
Yeah. That's all right. Go on in. Martini's a good friend of mine. There's a place to sit down. Come on, sit down. Oh, hello, Nick. Hey, where's Martini?
You want a martini?
No, Martini, your boss. Where is he?
Look, I'm the boss. You want a drink, or don't you?
Okay, all right. Double bourbon quick, huh?
Okay. What's yours?
I was just thinking. It's been so long since I...
Look, mister, I'm standing here waiting for you to make up your mind.
That's a good man. I was just thinking of a flaming rum punch. No, it's not cold enough for that. Not nearly cold enough. But wait a minute. I've got it. Mulled wine. Heavy on the cinnamon and light on the cloves. Off with you, me lad. And be lively.
Hey, look, mister. We serve hard drinks in here for men who want to get drunk fast. And we don't need any characters around to give you the joint atmosphere. Is that clear? Or do I have to slip you my left for a convincer?
What's he talking about?
Nick, just give him the same as mine. He's okay.
Okay.
What's the matter with him? I never saw Nick act like that before.
You'll see a lot of strange things from now on.
Oh, yeah. Hey, little fellow, you worry me. You got someplace to sleep?
No.
You don't, huh? What, you got any money?
No.
No wonder you jumped in the river.
I jumped in the river to save you, so I could get my wings.
Oh, that's right, yeah.
Oh, somebody just made it.
Made what?
Every time you hear a bell ring, it means that some angel's just got his wings.
Look, I think maybe you better not mention getting your wings around here.
Why? Don't they believe in angels?
Yeah, but you know.
Then why should they be surprised when they see one?
He never grew up. He's, How old are you anyway, Clarence?
293 next May.
That does it. Out you two pixies go. Through the door or out the window.
Look, Nick, what's wrong?
And that's another thing. Where do you come off calling me Nick?
Nick, that's your name, isn't it?
What's that got to do with it? I don't know you from Adam's or Fox. Hey, you. Rummy. Come here. Didn't I tell you never to come panhandling around here?
Mr. Gower. But Mr. Gower, this is George Bailey. Don't you know me?
No.
Throw him out.
Hey, what is... Hey, Nick. Nick, isn't that Mr. Gower, the druggist?
You know, that's another reason for me not to like you. That rumhead spent 20 years in jail for poisoning a kid. If you know him, you must be a jailbird yourself. Would you show these gentlemen to the door?
Sure. This way, gentlemen.
Hey, get me. I'm giving out wings.
You see, George, you were not there to stop Gower from putting that poison into the...
What do you mean I wasn't there? I remember distinctly. What the... Hey. What's going on here? Why this ought to be Martini's place? Why does it say Nick's place?
Okay, look, who are you?
I told you, George. I'm your guardian angel.
Yeah, I know. You told me that. What else are you? What are you, a hypnotist?
No, of course not.
Oh, well, then why am I seeing all these strange things?
Don't you understand, George? It's because you were not born.
Well, then if I wasn't born, who am I?
You're nobody. You have no identity.
What do you mean, no identity? My name's George Bailey.
There is no George Bailey. You have no papers, no cards, no driver's license, no 4F card, no insurance policy. They're not there either.
What?
Zuzu's petals. You've been given a great gift, George. A chance to see what the world would be like without you.
Now wait a minute here. As this is some sort of funny dreams I'm having here. So long, mister, I'm going home.
Home? What home?
Oh, now shut up, cut it out! You're crazy, that's what I think. You're screwy, and you're driving me crazy too, and I'm seeing things. I'm going home to see my wife and my family. Do you understand that? I'm going home alone.
How am I doing, Joseph? Thanks. No, I didn't have a drink.
Pottersville. Hey. Hey, where did the building and loan move to?
The building and what?
The Bailey building and loan. It was up there.
They went out of business years ago.
Stop. No, stop.
Hey, Violet. Hey, listen, that's Violet Bick.
I know.
I know that girl. Hey, Ernie, take me home. I'm off my nut.
Where do you live?
Oh, now, doggone it, Ernie. Don't you start pulling that stuff. You know where I live. 320 Sycamore. Now, hurry up.
Okay, 320 Sycamore?
Yeah, hurry up. Zuzu's sick. All right, look here, Ernie. Straighten me out here. Oh, I've got some bad liquor or something. Listen to me now. Now, you are Ernie Bishop, and you live in Bailey Park with your wife and kid. That's right, isn't it?
You see my wife?
Seen your wife? I've been to your house 100 times.
Look, bud, what's the idea? I live in a shack in Pottersfield. My wife ran away 3 years ago, and she took the kid. And I ain't never, ever seen you before in my life.
Okay, just step on it. Just get me home.
Is this the place?
Of course it's the place.
Well, this house ain't been lived in for 20 years.
What's up, Ernie?
I don't know, but we better keep an eye on this guy. He's bats.
Mary! Tommy, Pete, Janie, Zuzu! Where are you?
They're not here, George. You have no children.
Where are you? What have you done with them?
All right, put your hands up. No fast moves. Come on out here, both of you.
Bert, thank heaven you're here.
Stand back!
Bert, what's happened to this house? Where's Mary? Where's my kids?
Watch them, Bert.
Come on.
Bert! Ernie! What's the matter with you two guys? You were here on my wedding night. You both of you sit out here on the porch and sung to us, don't you remember?
Yeah, I think I'd better be going.
Look, now why don't you be a good kid? We'll take you to a doctor. Everything's going to be all right.
Bert, now listen to me. Ernie, will you take me over to my mother's house? Bert, listen. It's that fellow there. He says he's an angel. He's tried to hypnotize me.
Hate to do this to you, fella.
Run, George! Run, George! Help! Joseph, help!
Oh, shut up!
Help, oh, Joseph! Help, Joseph!
Where'd he go? I had him right here.
I need a drink.
Well, which way did they go? Help me find him.
Well?
Mother?
Mother, what do you want?
Mother, this is George. I thought sure you'd remember me.
George who? If you're looking for a room, there's no vacancy.
Oh, mother, 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 please help me. Something's terrible happened to me. I don't know what it is. Something's happened to everybody. Oh, please let me come in. Keep me here until I get over it.
Get over what? I don't take in strangers unless they're sent by somebody I know.
Well, I know everybody you know. Your brother-in-law, Uncle Billy.
You know him?
Well, sure I do.
When did you last see him?
Today, over at the house.
That's a lie. He's been in the insane asylum ever since he lost his business. And if you ask me, that's where you belong.
Strange, isn't it? Each man's life touches so many other lives. And when he isn't around, he leaves an awful hole, doesn't he?
I've heard of things like this. You got me some kind of a spell or something. Well, I'm going to get out of it. I'll get out of it. I know how to. The last man I talked to before all this stuff started happening to me was Martini.
You know where he lives?
Sure, I know where he lives. He lives in Bailey Park.
Are you sure this is Bailey Park?
Oh, I'm not sure of anything anymore. All I know is this is where the Bailey Park should be. But where are the houses?
You weren't here to build them.
It's just a cemetery.
Your brother, Harry Bailey, broke through the ice and was drowned at the age of 9.
That's a lie! Harry Bailey went to war. He got the Congressional Medal of Honor. He saved the lives of every man on that transport.
Every man on that transport died. Harry wasn't there to save them because you weren't there to save Harry. You see, George, you really had a wonderful life. Don't you see what a mistake it would be to throw it away?
Clarence, where's Mary?
Oh, well, I can't.
I don't know how you know these things, but tell me where she is. If you know where she is, tell me where my wife is.
I'm not supposed to tell.
Please, Claire, tell me where she is.
Oh, you're not going to like it, George.
Where is she?
She's an old maid. She never married.
Where is she?
She's...
Where's Mary? Where is she?
She's just about to close up the library. There must be some easier way for me to get my wings.
Mary! Mary! Mary, Mary! Mary, it's George. Don't you know me? What's happened to us?
I don't know you. Let me
Mary,
go!
Please, don't do this to me, Mary. Please help me. Please help. Where's our kids? I need you, Mary. Help me. Mary! Mary! Let me go, Mary. Don't run away.
Somebody call the police. Hit him with a bottle.
He needs a straitjacket.
That man! Stop him!
Tom. Charlie. Ed. That's my wife. Mary!
Oh, no you don't.
Mary! Clarence! Clarence, where are you?
Oh, it's you! Stand back! Everyone, stand back!
Clarence! Clarence, help me, please, Clarence. Get me back, I don't care what happens to me, only get me back to my wife. Kids, help me, Clarence, please. Please, I want to live again. I want to live again, please. God, let me live again.
George, you all right? Hey, what's the matter?
Now get out of here, Bert, or I'll hit you again. Get out.
What the Sam Hill are you yelling for, George?
Don't... George? Bert, do you know me?
Know you? Are you kidding? I've been looking for you all over town, trying to find you. I saw your car piled into that tree down there, and I thought maybe... Hey, your mouth's bleeding. Are you sure you're all right?
What did? My mouth's bleeding, Bert. My mouth's bleeding. Zuzu's petals. Zuzu's... They're here. They're here. Bert, what do you know about that? Merry Christmas! Mary! Hello, Bedford Falls! Merry Christmas! Oh, Merry Christmas, Movie House! Merry Christmas, Emporium! Oh, Merry Christmas, you wonderful old building and loan!
Happy New Year to you, too. In jail? Go on home. They're waiting for you.
Mary! Oh, hello, Mr. Bank Examiner.
Mr. Bailey, there's a deficit.
I know. $8,000. Well, I'll bet it's a warrant for my arrest. Isn't it wonderful? Merry Christmas! Reporters! Hey, where's Mary? Mary! Oh, look at this wonderful old drafty house. Mary! Have you seen my wife? Kids! Oh, Pete, kids. Janie, Tommy. Oh, I could eat you all up.
Merry Christmas, Daddy.
Where's your mother?
She went looking for you with Uncle Billy. Daddy!
Zuzu, my little ginger snap. How do you feel?
I'm fine. And not a smidge of temperature.
Not a smidge of temperature. Hallelujah.
Hello. George,
oh,
darling.
Mary.
George, darling, where have you been?
Mary, let me touch you.
Oh, George. George. Oh, George.
You have no idea what's happened to me.
You have no idea what happened. Well, come on, George. Come downstairs, quick. They're on their way.
Well, all right.
Come on in here now. Now you stand right over there by the tree. Right there and don't move. Don't move. I hear him now, George. It's a miracle. Come in, Uncle Billy. Everybody, in here.
Isn't it wonderful? Mary did it, George. Mary did it. She told a few people in town that you were in trouble, and they scattered all over collecting money. They didn't ask questions. Just said, if George is in trouble, count on me. You never saw anything like it.
What is this, George? Another run on the bank? And here, George, I got the faculty all up out of bed. Here's something for you too, little one.
The line forms on the right. Mr. Martini, Merry Christmas. Step right up here.
I busted the jukebox, too.
Mr. Gower.
Violet, Beck.
I'm not going to go, George. I changed my mind.
I've been saving this money for a divorce, if I ever get a husband.
I wouldn't have a roof over my head if it wasn't for you, George.
All right, just a minute. Quiet, everybody, quiet. Now, this is from London. Mr. Gower cables you need cash. Stop. My office instructed to advance you up to $25,000. Stop. Hee-haw and Merry Christmas. Sam Wainwright.
Mr. Martini, how about some wine?
Hello, George. How are you?
Harry. Oh, Harry.
Mary, looks like I got here too late.
Mary, I got him here as quickly as I could. The fool flew all the way here through a blizzard.
Harry, how about your banquet in New York?
Oh, I left right in the middle of it as soon as I got Mary's telegram. Good idea, Ernie. A toast. To my big brother, George. The richest man in town.
What's that?
It's a Christmas present from a very dear friend of mine.
Dear George, remember, no man is a failure who has friends. Thanks for the wings. Love, Clarence.
Look, Daddy. Teacher says every time a bell rings, an angel gets his wings.
That's right. That's right. Attaboy, Clarence. Attaboy.
Thanks for listening. We hope you enjoyed this production of It's a Wonderful Life. This production starred Chris Dane as George Bailey, Jillian Laganelli as Mary Hatch, Nick Cancelliere as Mr. Potter, Joseph Sibilia as Clarence, Greg Nugent as Uncle Billy and Mickey, Kyle Borringer as Harry Bailey, Ryan Cadena as Sam Wainwright, Lindsay Crescenti as Violet Bick, Dennis Quinn as Mr. Gower, Eric Adams as Bert the Cop, Connor Adams as Ernie the Cab Driver, Jasmine Gonzalez as Annie, John Potito as the Voice of God, Nicole Caico as Ma Bailey, Zack Grinfeld as Pa Bailey, Homeowner and Sheriff, Megan McGuire as Cousin Eustace, Bankwoman No. 2, Woman, and Pete, Zach Alexander as Joseph and Nick, Bradley Clarke as Mr. Martini, Reineman, and the Tollkeeper, Jessica Ma as Cousin Tilly, Schultz, and Zuzu, Sean Bates as Joe, Dr. Campbell, and Charlie, Sean Morgan as Principal Tom Partridge and Mr. Welch, Sam Friedland as Freddy, Bankman, and Man Helping Bert, Carissa Hensel as Jackie, Potter's Secretary, and Tommy, Bianca Kroening as Woman at House, Mrs. Davis, and Janie, Indiana Messier as Lawyer, Violet's Suitor No. 2, Bankman No. 3, and Man. Logan Kelly as Chairman, Violet's Suitors No. 1, Carter, and Cop. Sarah Grace Sanders as Ruth, Randall, and Bank Teller. Heidi Gleickauf as Mrs. Hatch and Bankwoman No. 1. Celia Warner as Passerby and Jane. Elisa Delia as Ed, Mrs. Martini, and Kid Sam. And Chelsea Nelson Fernandez as Mrs. Thompson and Driver. Once again, thank you for listening to this production of It's a Wonderful Life by Francis Goodrich, Albert Hackett, Frank Capra, and Jo Swerling. Happy holidays, everyone, and Merry Christmas to you all.
Not a cloud in the sky. Mr. Cupid just winked his eye, and you walked by. It's a wonderful life. I have more than my share. See me walking around on air because you care. 7th heaven isn't up so far. I see heaven from my lucky star. It's a wonderful life. Let it rain, let it shine. It's as wonderful as can be because you're mine.